In the energy quadrant today, oil a little bit lower, down 1.6% on settlement. At the lows, it was down 1.8%. September crude oil contract got down to about 40.85 on the lows, down 1.8% on the high side, 41.93. So still well within the range we've talked about quite a bit. That high side was only up 33 basis points. And as I mentioned, we actually finished lower about 1.6%. So nearer to the lows. There's some concerns over the GOP Senate fiscal stimulus package, which there's still plenty of work to do to see if that actually gets done and could potentially spark some general economic demand, which could affect the long side of crude oil prices. There is more supply coming other than just the OPEC agreement to kind of curtail the production cuts. And that's in the Canadian oil sands, which is something we don't talk that much about. IHS Markit says Canadian oil sands is expected to grow production in 2021 and 2022. This year marks the single biggest drop in Canadian oil sands production on record. 700,000 barrels of oil sands taken offline in Q2 alone. But as I mentioned, 2021 and 2022 production is expected to rise not only above this year, but above pre-COVID levels by about 300,000 barrels. So it's definitely important that the demand side of things start to pick up if U.S. shale is going to get prices where they can start to pick up demand, and if OPEC is not going to collapse prices with this particular slight curtailing of those production cuts that are expected to start in August. Now, tomorrow, we have EIA data, and it's not really the builder draws that will matter in the medium term. It's going to be refinery utilization. That's the key. We had a streak of 9 consecutive refinery utilization increases end last week. We had a slight dip, still well above 75%, but still it was off from the week before. It was 9 consecutive weeks higher, and in those 9 consecutive weeks higher, the price of crude oil rose 7 of those 9 weeks. So it's important tomorrow to see if refinery utilization recovers back above not only last week's level, but the prior week's level, to keep that streak of increased perceived demand at the refinery level in place, but just to make sure that it doesn't slip anymore, because if it does, that means refineries are not seeing enough demand on the ground to pull those crude oil supplies out.